Good morning, I'm Robin van Holdt, Chief Executive of Top 100 SA Wines, and it's very pleasing to welcome Higgo Jacobs into the studio. Higgo was Tasting Director of the 2011 Inaugural Challenge for Top 100 SA Wines, and he will again be fulfilling that role this year. Hi, Higgo.
Good morning, Robin.
How are things on the fine wine scene, Higgo?
Very good, I think. There's loads of great wines out there, but of course we're focused and talking specifically about the top 100 winners for 2011's challenge. I think it's been a great result and a great book out there.
It has, hasn't it? And we've had very good feedback from vineyards and from consumers about how people have been drinking the top 100 SA wines very, very happily. Tremendous feedback. Most vineyards, as we gather at this point, are totally sold out of their winning wines from last year. And perhaps that's not a bad thing, considering that the 2012 challenge opened on Tuesday this week.
Mm. So from a consumer point of view, it's been debunking the myth, as you've always talked up, in getting these wines out there. And clearly they've noticed. I think it's been showing the success on the internet, online hits.
Yeah, we've had a remarkable progress over the first year. And to look at that in some detail, it seems like not thousands, but tens of thousands of people are hitting our website trying to find out more about the top 100 wines and, in fact, trying to buy them. And a couple of statistics might evoke curiosity from listeners. There have been 17,000 unique visitors, 75,000 page views, and 1.6 million hits on the top 100 SA Wines website. The brand top 100 SA Wines is already on 110,000 web pages around the world, and there are 900 web pages that link directly to our website. From a Google point of view, what's fascinating is that if you feed in buy SA Wines, we're already ranked 7th, and that's after 1 year. Mm-hmm. So the translation is, winners' wines are being sought, winners' wines are being bought.
Certainly very positive for the vineyards in terms of getting the right kind of consumer, noticing the wines, and of course these are fine wines we're talking about, so it's a list of 100 wines. It's always been very easy access for the consumer, and new innovations for next year will make that even easier, Robin.
I think that's right, and hopefully it'll prove to be true. And, you know, I'll quote a simple example. We had winners in 2011 who, from a price point of view, ranged from very affordable to quite expensive. Now, the good news is they're pretty much all sold out. But the more good news is this year in the challenge, we will again be identifying only the top 100 SA wines, regardless of price. But having said that, if a wine retails for 100 rand or less a bottle, it will get a second award, it'll get a value award, and these will be identified very easily. So consumers who are feeling a pinch in their wallet given economic times will be able to drink great wines and affordable great wines.
We certainly had some stellar value wines in the 2011 guide, Robin, haven't we? If you consider that these are wines rated by MWs to be worthy of a top 100 SA wine status, and then if you look at the price point, it's almost been surprising. So it's stunning that we're including that value award then for the 2012 challenge.
And it's a beautiful result, isn't it, when premium wines are frankly affordable pretty much by most people. That's a glorious result.
There will now also be a quick response code being introduced for the vineyard. So when a consumer is interested in a wine, he can click on it and it goes right onto the winery's page.
That's right. I think the first point is buy the book, have the book, because it gives you all the information that you need. The second point is, frankly, whip out your smartphone, and in a fraction of a second later, your phone will take you right the way through to the Winning Vineyards website, where you'll be able to do whatever it is that you want to do with that vineyard, whether it's buy wine, go to the restaurant, book a tasting, whatever. So yes, we're moving ahead with technology rapidly. There are a few other innovations as well. We've invested in an electronic entry system, which is a first in South Africa and one of the first in the world. So vineyards will be able to enter online just pressing a few keys.
You were also mentioning that there might be a UK office opening up.
Indeed, we're opening a UK office for marketing purposes later this year. And I think given time, we need to move on. But The final point I'd like to make from a consumer point of view is at the tasting festivals, at the one and only in Cape Town and in Johannesburg in May, we'll also be having a museum class of wines. So wines winning the year before will be available for tasting.
Stunning.
Thanks for your time.